That is a ginormous one. Back in 2022, I did the Penang Round Island in Malaysia. I thoroughly enjoyed it. And it was then that I decided that I would do the Singapore Round Island too. I then shared my plans with my cousin who lives in Singapore. And he thought it was a great idea and decided to join in the adventure. This is our story. The plan is to complete the Round Island in 2 days. Day one is mainly on the east coast and day two is the west coast. First thing in the morning, but it's okay now. Okay. I just realized that Singapore has got many bus stands. We can always stop.
Okay.
All right. So, first things first, breakfast. What do you want? Where should we do? Do it in Punggol, do it here, whichever way.
Punggol?
Punggol, okay. Oh. Let's go.
Okay, the first stop is MRT. Right?
Ah, yeah. Our starting point is in Punggol MRT. MRT is Mass Rapid Transit. It is the equivalent of London Underground, but nicer.
Wow.
Oh wow, what's that?
It's nice, right?
Oh, you got auntie exercising in the morning. The first job is to look for some breakfast. That should be easy enough, if you know the way, that is. If you've never been to Singapore before, Singapore is a bit like a concrete jungle. It should be easy enough to find eating places tucked away between buildings and flats.
Kopitiam breakfast, coffee, crispy kaya butter.
Oh,
the egg is 2 more minutes, right?
2 more minutes, yeah.
I'm having runny eggs, toast with kaya and butter. You really can't go wrong with this one. The best way to cook runny eggs is to grab a couple of fresh eggs and soak them in boiling water for 7 minutes and then crack it open, a dollop of light soy sauce and sprinkle it with some ground white pepper. It was so good to catch up with my cousin BS, just like the old days. And before you know it, it's gone past 7 a.m. It's time to get going. Good old BS had never cycled more than 7 miles before, so this would be an interesting trial. And if he could complete the journey, then he really does deserve an award. It wouldn't surprise me if that tortoise is older than I am. The lifespan of an average tortoise is roughly 80 to 150 years. You could quite easily outlive a human.
Thank you.
Coney Island is probably the last one or two remaining islands in Singapore that is underdeveloped. But as you can see, development has begun. This particular section is not too dissimilar from Friston Forest near Eastbourne in Sussex. We have just exited Coney Island from the West Gate.
This is right after Coney Island. So far, so good.
It is not obvious to us at this point that we were in fact going around one big loop. I must have misconfigured the sat-nav. And as a result, we have added something like 10 miles to our journey.
Yeah, follow the pedestrians. Go straight, turn right. And you can see the scenery. We must be like Hollywood actors. You never look at the camera. Unless you are narrating like Morgan Freeman. And now we are going through the most exotic bridge in the world. What was that?
This is the Seletar link.
Have to wait for the old man behind me, he's a bit slow.
Seletar link was meant to have been a connection and should take us directly to Woodlands, except that it was a dead end. It is still under construction. So we had to backtrack.
We are still on the Seletar link.
Some of you may notice from the map that we are in fact traveling counterclockwise. I hadn't realized it at the time. Having realized my mistake, I recalibrated the sat nav device and we are now on the right track. Because of the heavy downpour, we've decided to wait at the bus stand. And when the rain stopped, we cycled away, leaving behind my GoPro. It must have been about half a mile or so later that I realized that I left my camera behind. And so we had to backtrack to retrieve the camera.
About 12, 13 miles to go, about 3 hours of cycling. This is Changi Air Base to the right. Cycle path.
Look at this, a cycle path in between two major roads.
It looks like a swamp to me. If you have beach, you could go on for miles and it looks really nice. See, I have to set up a tent there. Ah, can feel, oh. Bye bye, day.
raining this morning. All the retirees are not out.
It is not
beach park
obvious in the video, but at this point, the BS soldiered on in spite of all the pains and aches all over his body. See it, but the sun is absolutely boiling in here.
Asking to do the round island. Gardens by the bay.
It may not be very obvious from the video, but the evening sunset at Marina Bay is absolutely gorgeous. Well, I guess day one is coming to an end. The original plan was to cycle 38 miles. We did 49. And if you're still watching, join us in the next episode.